3 ways to help you to stop being the nice guy. Now, first off, can I just say that I love my nice guys. Hi, if you don't know who I am, let me introduce myself. My name is Arica Angelo, and I am the CEO and I'm the founder of the Arica Angelo Intimacy Experience. And some of my nice guys out there are watching going, Arica, I would love to have some intimacy, but I can't even get there because I'm too nice. Well, I have your attention. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on that notification bell so you can know when another video is coming your way. I love me some nice guys. I typically get into relationship with the nice guys, but there's that line there where you're the nice guy and then you're the guy just completely getting taken advantage of. And we do not want that for you. No, we don't. Listen, my nice guy, while I love you, while I support you, while I champion you, I have worked with plenty of you. And there's one thing you all do. You all justify it. Get defiant with me. You defend why you're so nice. But that is keeping you stuck. Just listen to me, babe, because I want you to be with a woman who's gonna love you just as much as you want it. So let's do this together. So don't justify your actions. Let's just look at a way to improve and get better. Because the last thing we want is for the world to keep passing you by, for woman after woman to keep coming and going through your life without you getting the chance, without you having the opportunity to be the greatest lover to her and for her to be the greatest lover to you. Number one, I want to introduce something to you called over responsibility. You know what I'm talking about. You're the guy, you're responsible for everything. Did I say something wrong? Oh, are you okay? I can make it better. Oh, she's in a bad mood. I know, it's my job to make it all better. I'm gonna make her happy. No, baby. Your over-responsibility is putting you in the nice guy category. And listen, over-responsibility, while it sounds good, it sounds helpful, you think you're just trying to help her out. What you're doing is you're putting yourself on the back burner. Excuse me if I get a little deep here. Sometimes we're over-responsible because we don't want to be responsible for ourselves. And you cannot be over-responsible for her. It's okay to be gracious. It's okay to be sweet. But say it with me. She is not my responsibility. Say it. Go ahead. I'm waiting for you. Let's change it around. I am my responsibility. I am responsible for my happiness. I am responsible if I am okay. She is not my responsibility. Women, we feel that vibe. We can feel you being over-responsible. We know that when we push you here and push you there and you go for it every time, that you're prioritizing us over you. Whether you're a male or a female, it doesn't matter. We can feel when a person doesn't value themselves and they're prioritizing us over them. It may work out for a little short time. Over the long haul, we tend to value and navigate towards people. We're drawn to people who have a good sense of value for themselves. Which leads me to number two. Start developing your own value. That's right, babe. While you cannot be over-responsible for her and over-responsible for her happiness and if she's okay and if this worked out and that worked out, what you can do is be responsible for you. And by you showing up for you, you become more sexier. She goes, oh, look at that man over there. Okay, he's taking care of himself. I like it. I like what he's doing. It looks good on him. Okay. Value yourself practically. When's the last time you've taken yourself on a trip? Go out to dinner with one of your boys and instead of just spending your money on dating a woman, spend some money on you. Take yourself out on a nice dinner date. Well, it's not a date, you're going with your guy, but a nice dinner with your guy friend. Order that good juicy steak. Order a nice bottle of wine. Treat yourself. Go on a hike. Spend time with nature. The point is, find things that resonate with you. What are things that you would do with her to take her out on a date? Now stop and think, why do I do these things for her? Because you want her to feel valued. You want her to feel special. But are you making you feel special? Because you gotta take care of you. You gotta be responsible for you. because baby doll, there's only one you and we don't get another of you. So if you don't take care of you, nobody else will. And Mama Erica Angelo wants you to take good care of yourself. Why? Because we love you, baby. Think of all the things that you would do for her if you had her in your life, the kind of dates that you would take her on. And then take yourself on those dates. Do those things for yourself. You're so worried about how you're gonna date her, but baby, you gotta date you. I will tell you something that a wise woman once told me. She said this, Erica, you can't give out what you don't have. That's right. You can't keep being responsible for her and valuing her if you're not being responsible and valuing yourself. So be responsible for your own happiness. Be responsible for your own joy. Be responsible for your own value by taking care of you, doing the things that you'd be willing to do for her, spending the money that you'd be willing to spend on her, and spend it on yourself. Do those things on yourself. Take care of you. When you show up in women's lives, they can feel it. We feel that sense of, this is a man who prioritizes himself. So if he can take care of him, then guess what? He'll be able to show up for me as well. And here is my third ultimate nice guy breaker. Speak up for yourself. Did you ever watch the King's Speech where the guy's like, you have a voice. You have a voice. You have a voice. When I'm working with my single guys, that is what I say to them all the time in coaching. Baby, you have a voice. But sometimes my nice guys, when they get with that pretty girl, all of a sudden that voice goes into, yes, yes, no. You gotta have a voice. You gotta speak up for yourself. Speaking up for yourself means taking these things out of your vocabulary. No, I don't care. It doesn't really matter to me. What do you want to do? Oh, whatever you think. I'm just happy to do whatever you want to do. No. This is back to having value for yourself. Speak up. Say the things that you want. So when she says to you, you know, I'd really like to go shopping today. Instead, you say, you know what? That could be great for another day. I was actually thinking that you and I go on a hike today. There's this beautiful trail. There are these amazing trees. I think you're gonna fall in love with them. And I think we can get some good pictures for your Instagram. Just created a win-win for both of you. She gets to feed her Instagram and you get to speak up for yourself and do the activity that you actually really wanted to do. What a concept. If you're going out to get food and she just says, I don't know what I want to eat. It's okay, it's fine. I know exactly what we can do. We're gonna go to this Mexican restaurant. They have the best margaritas and the best tacos. You're gonna love it. Using your voice is imperative because let me tell you, if you can learn this now, when you get into a relationship, you can show up, be your own advocate, and start using your voice to let her know, listen, I value myself. In fact, I think that is one of the most important things that a man can learn in 2019 is how to use his own voice. I see it in relationships, I see it among singles, and even in marriages. When men don't know how to use their voice, their women end up frustrated. Regardless of what the women do, you gotta use your voice for you because you value you and it's your own personal responsibility. So those are my three ways to abolish the nice guy. One, get rid of over-responsibility. Two, baby doll, get some value for yourself. And three, speak up for yourself. There's nothing wrong with being a nice guy, but there is a problem when you start prioritizing everybody else above yourself. And that, my dear, is not okay. Baby, if you like this video, leave me a comment. Tell me, what part did you see yourself in? Because I can't wait to chat with you in the comment thread below. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and hey, share it with a friend. Until next time, I am sending you all my love, you sweet, nice guy. Kisses to you and that beautiful, gorgeous heart of yours. Now let's shape up. Why do these planes always fly when I'm in the middle of shooting YouTube? Don't these people know? What is she talking about? What is that Erica Angelo talking about?
You are ruining the intimacy experience. Treat yourself.
Because you can't give what you don't have, baby.